Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be painting a blue butterfly. I've been doing butterflies all week and I've really enjoyed painting these, so I thought I'd do a tutorial on it. The colors that we're going to be using are phthalo blue, raw umber, black, titanium white, and a orange or like a vermilion. That's not it. A vermilion or like an orangey kind of color. It doesn't have to be a specific, just some type of orangey color. We're just going to use a little bit of that. So to get started, here are our brushes. We're just going to use three simple brushes. We'll have a kind of like a small round, a small filbert, and then a liner brush. So we're gonna start with our small round, and the easiest way to do butterflies, I'll show you. We're just gonna kind of get some raw umber and water it down a lot, just so we can do a little sketch. And we want the top of the wings to stop about here. So just do that line. This is super watered down so we can paint over it. And then the bottom of the wings will go about here. I can't do a straight line today. That's just to give us some parameters there. Okay, and then we'll still take that raw umber mixture. And the easiest way I've found is just to, it almost looks like an X, but we'll start here, bring it around, bring it down, just stay with me, it'll make sense in a minute. And then we'll do that on the other side as well. So about here. And we can refine this little sketch. Okay. And that's just so we kind of know where we want things to go. And I'm watering down a little bit more raw umber, and on this side this will be a wing. We'll kind of do, and then we'll do the same thing on this side, wing, and we'll kind of do like little squigglies. Okay, and then on this side we'll do that, and on this side we'll do that. And so we pretty much have symmetrical sides. We're gonna have a little this will be a little body. And all of this will get darkened up, but right now we just want it to be a light sketch. Okay. And we can change this if we want. We think the wings aren't big enough. All of this will get covered. But it's just a good starting point, and you can redefine. Okay, so you can rinse your brush out. We have like our little sketch. And one more brush I want to add is maybe like a little bit larger brush just to do the background. And this could be a flat or an angle. It's like a medium size, just so it doesn't take forever to do the background. And for the background, I want to get some raw umber, a little bit of white to gray it a little bit. We're just going to have a simple background and we're going to go all the way around our sketch. We might have to do more than one coat. I think I want to add in a little bit more white. It's a little dark for me. We have this pretty kind of grayish color. And we're just going to go all around our sketch. Like I said, we'll probably do another coat of this, and we might go a little bit even lighter than this. Good thing about acrylic paints is that if you make a mistake or you don't like something, all you got to do is let it dry and then paint over it. Pretty easy to correct things. Like this wing here, I'll correct that a little bit later. So I'll get a little bit more white this time with the raw umber and lighten it up quite a bit. And I just want to do another coat in the background. And I'm using a 7x9 canvas panel, but you can use whatever you want and make it proportional. If your brush gets a little dry, you can dip it in water. Not too much, but just a little bit. Okay, so we have the background done. You can rinse your brush out. And I might want to make these top wings bigger. We'll see. If you want to redefine your wings a little bit, just get some more raw umber. I see that I need to do a little bit of. And just follow along with me. All of this brown will get covered up. I think that's good. I think that's good. Okay, you can rinse your brush out if you're done defining your wings there. We're gonna use our small little filbert, And some phthalo blue. Phthalo blue is really pigmented. A little bit will take you a long way. So we're going to kind of map out how these wings will go. Just follow along with me. I'm just going to get some definition in these wings a little bit. We'll get some. Okay. And we'll do the same thing on this side. Kind of where we want the blue color to go. Do the same thing over here. And then over here. And then we can just fill these areas in with the blue. We'll define it some more. But we just want to get our base color down. And then we can go from there and start shading and all that fun stuff. And this is, again, just phthalo blue. There's no mixture. It's just phthalo blue. I've watered it down just a tad. I'm just filling all this in. Okay, now we're going to go into our black, and this is just straight black. It's okay if you don't rinse your brush out, and we're just going to use our brush to like outline this in black, and I think I will make the top wings a little bit bigger, so I'm going to go down like this. I'm keeping the shape mostly, but just make them a little bit bigger. And I'm going to do the same thing on this side. I'm just going to come out just a little bit further. The bottom wings I'm okay with a little bit. So I'm just gonna follow where we made our sketch. Okay. And we're gonna put it in his little body. It's just like a little circle here, and then kind of like a oval shape here. And fill it in. Okay. You can rinse out your brush. I'm just going to fill in a little bit more of this blue. Just a little bit more. I have a little black in there, but that's okay, because some of it will get covered up. And that's phthalo blue. Since we kind of changed the parameter. Just a little bit. Well, I dragged some black. Not to panic, not to panic. Anything can be fixed if you let it dry. Okay. And you can rinse your brush out again. We'll go back into our black and we're just going to define these wings. Just with black now. And we'll do the same thing on the other side. We're just making these little swooping. Do the bottom wings as well. And we'll do the other side. Fill it in. You can rinse your brush out, and we're gonna go back to our liner brush to do these kind of veins in the wings. We're going to start here. bring it down. And we'll do that on the other side. Bring it down. We'll do it for this side as well. And remember, the lighter pressure you put, the thinner the line. So if you press down really hard, your lines will be really thick. And then we'll do the bottom wings. Rinse your brush out. Before we go any further, I think I want to do the background one more time. I want to make it lighter. As you know, acrylics dry darker. So sometimes you can't always see what it's going to look like until it's done being dry. And you can decide if you want to change it up a little bit. So I've added it's raw umber and a lot of white this time. I'm just gonna go around. And I'm just putting a light coat over this just to lighten it up just a little bit. And I've added a little bit too much water. But I'm just gonna go with it. I'm also using this small brush, so it'll take a little bit longer to do, but that's okay. I just want to get some of this lighter color in there. I didn't like the darker brown tan color. I just want to lighten it up a little bit. And you can use a bigger brush for this if you want. I'm trying not to go into my black. I don't want to have to paint that over again. If you like the way yours looks, you don't have to do this part. If you like the darker background. So this mixture again is just raw umber and lots of white. don't know if you can even tell the difference on camera. I can tell the difference here, but you might not be able to tell the difference on camera, but it does make a big difference. Okay, you can rinse your brush out. Now we're going to get some phthalo blue, a little bit of white, and lighten that up a little bit. And we're just going to start putting in some highlights. I need a little bit more white. Start putting in some highlights. We're just going to do this side. Do the bottom. I'm going to put in a couple highlights down there as well. You can kind of redefine your little wings as you go if you need to. And I'm going to add even more white to do a couple little highlights. I'm adding a little bit more white to that phthalo blue. And I'm just doing quick little strokes. Trying not to overthink it. And I might come back in with some phthalo blue. I messed up my little line there, and I can put that back in. I'm going to put my little line back in that I accidentally went over. I'm going to use my small round. And I want to be kind of precious because there's a lot of white. And I don't want it to just turn gray on me. See if I can do it. Okay. I'm just gonna do this little body again. And I'm going to go over the outside again. So if any of your little lines disappeared, you can put them back in now. Put his little antenna in. Okay. I think I want to put some more of the phthalo blue, just phthalo blue, no white, and just put some of that color back in. Went a little crazy with the highlights, and I'm just sweeping, it's like a light pressure, just a sweeping gesture. You can rinse your brush out. We're going to take a little bit of raw umber, a little bit of white, I'm just gonna do some little highlights on his body here. Just a couple. We have to let some of this dry up top where we're gonna take our orange and just do a couple little dots down here. A couple little dots. And over here, we'll do a little dot. And again, over here, do a little dot. We'll take some white. We'll do a couple little. Now, if yours is still wet, be careful. Mine is still wet a little bit, so I can't do it there, but we can put some little dots down here. There. We'll also put a couple. Couple little highlights around. And these are just little light strokes. And I think I can put my little dots up here now. I'm going into our orange or my vermilion. I'm adding a little bit of white. I'm gonna just go back, put some highlights on this orange color. Now, this is pretty much done. If you want, you can get your little, your small liner brush. And I like to line it just a little bit in places here and there with white. You don't have to do the whole outline, just little pops of color. Just really light pressure when you're doing this, so you can make the line as thin as possible. If you don't like the way this looks, you don't have to do this part. And that is it. If you have any questions, let me know, or comments, leave them below. I'd love to answer them. I hope you enjoyed painting this with me, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.